Hello, my dear friends. Welcome to an interesting and fascinating chapter of story time. Today, I'm telling a story of a brave boy who saved the forest through his wisdom. It's me, Anmy Sato from story time. Now let me narrate a venturesome story named Jack and the Monster. Once there lived a poor boy in a village near to a forest. His parents died when he was very young. He made his living by picking up fruits that fell down from the trees. He used to go to the forest early in the morning every day. There he waited under a tree till the wind blew and shook the tree. He would collect the fruits in a basket and eat some of them to take care of his hunger. Then he would sell the rest of it in the market and buy whatever he needed for his daily life. He used to collect more fruits on the windy days and suffered from hunger when the wind was not kind to him. One day, as usual, Jack went to the forest to collect the fruits in the morning. But unfortunately, the wind was not in favor of Jack and he couldn't find any fruits on the ground. He sat under the tree waiting for the wind to blow. As the time passed by, Jack became very hungry and sad. At that time, a sage was passing through the forest and saw Jack weeping. The sage felt pity on the boy and asked him why he was crying. Jack told the sage his story and the sage felt a special affection towards him. So he decided to help the boy and he taught him a special mantra. Abracadabra, gili gili choo. My dear friends, do you know the use of this mantra? Okay, let me explain. If anyone chants this mantra by standing under a tree, the tree will start shaking as if by a strong wind and everything will fall to the ground. Jack was very happy and excited. From then on, he used this mantra to collect the fruits from the forest. After a few days, as usual, Jack went to the forest and stood below a big tree and he started to chant the mantra. Abracadabra, gili gili choo. The tree started shaking vigorously. The fruits began to fall from the tree. Then another terrible thing happened. With a loud sound, a big thing fell to the ground. It was nothing but a huge monster. The monster was sleeping on the top of the tree and violent shaking made him to fall down. The angry monster got up and ran towards Jack to kill him. The frightened boy begged the monster for pardon and he explained the whole story. On hearing the story, the monster calmed down, but put forward a demand. If you teach me that mantra, I will let you free. The frightened boy agreed hesitantly. Jack knew that if the monster learns the mantra, it can be dangerous to the forest and the animals living there. So he decided to play a trick on the monster and said, "Okay, I will teach you the mantra, but this place is not suitable for that." And he led the monster to another big tree. Jack knew that a big snake was living on the top branch of the tree. When the monster reached exactly under the branch on which the snake was living, the boy started to chant the mantra, pretending as if he was teaching to the monster. Abracadabra, gili gili choo! As he was chanting the mantra, the tree started shaking heavily. Dear friends, do you know what happened then? The big snake fell on the monster. The snake started to squeeze the monster with its full strength. The horrified monster cried out in pain, but the snake squeezed even stronger. After a long tussle, the monster finally died. Thus, all were saved from the clutches of the monster. Jack went back home happily. My dear friends, the moral of the story is, wisdom is power. See you again with another story. Till then, bye-bye.